1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Testing, 1, 2, 3. This is the National Wildlife Facility Range Control Center. We are counting down today for the launch of the Terry Improved Malamute Suborbital Sounding Rocket, carrying the Subtech 6 payload. Launch time this morning is targeted for 4:35:30 a.m. Eastern Time. At this point, we have checked out the payload system in both the vertical and the horizontal positions, and everything is looking good for the payload systems. Also, weather is reporting that we are looking a little bit better than yesterday. Right now, we are under clear skies at Wallops, and at launch time, we are predicting possibility of some scattered clouds, but we are looking a little bit better than yesterday. Rain Safety has reported that the first balloons have been launched and predictions have come in, and winds at the mid and upper altitudes are within limits for the launch. And they've also reported their first ship surveillance look, and we are we do have several boats out in the hazard impact area, and we are working with those boats and trying to get them to move in time for the launch. Also, just a reminder that this morning, NASA's Orbiting Carbon Observatory Tour, OCO 2, is scheduled for launch this morning at 5:56 a.m. Eastern Time from the Vandenberg Air Force Base in California. And you'll be able to catch that on NASA TV.
TD, RSO, Channel 1.
TD, go ahead.
Roger, ma'am. Results from balloon number 3, which is our first chaff balloon. Wind weighting is green.
Copy.
TDRSO, channel 1.
Go ahead.
Yeah, just a quick status update. No real change in the surveillance picture.
Copy. Thank you.
Roger. TD, PM, MM. This is RSO in Channel 1. Will you please meet me on Channel 5? RSO, Channel 1.
Go ahead.
Roger. Balloon number 4, second chaff balloon when waiting is green.
Copy.
T-minus 60 minutes and counting for the launch of the Terry and Prue Malamute with the Subtech 6 payload system. Range Safety just recently reported that they did fly a mid-altitude balloon, and the latest reports are that winds are within limits for launch. Also forecast for the launch this morning, we are currently in clear skies, and we are forecasting possibility of some scattered clouds, but not as strong as yesterday. So the forecast looks a little better for today's launch attempt versus yesterday's. Our biggest problem today is, again, going to be boats out in the hazard area. We are working to try to get those cleared out of the area. We do have several boats out there. We do realize it is fishing season, so we do expect to see some boats out in that area, so we're just working with them, and hopefully we can get things cleared out. Our impact area, our main impact area that we're looking at in the central part of the hazard area is one of the prime fishing areas in the Mid-Atlantic coast. And that's for both recreational and commercial fishing vessels. Our launch time this morning is targeted for 4:35:30 a.m. Eastern Time. So we'll continue to monitor the situation and see if we can get us a clean range. We do have a launch window that runs through tomorrow. If by chance we do not get off today, however, it will depend on probably on the forecast, which we will be given. If we don't launch today, we'll get an updated forecast and a determination for account for tomorrow. This is Wallace French Control. T-minus 50 minutes and counting for the launch of the Terrier Improved Malamute suborbital sounding rocket with the Subtech 6 payload. Continuing to count down this morning for a launch
RSO
at 4:35:30 a.m.
PM RSO 1, go ahead.
RSO, we were wondering if at this time we could get a surveillance update.
I'll meet you on 5.
RSO, could you conduct that update on channel 1?
I can. Currently, we're red for boats in the hazard area. We are having some success with the boats taking our direction and beginning moving out of the area, and they are supposed to be making best speed. Again, these are fishing vessels and are not making all that much more than 7 or 8 knots. The best that we can do is continue as we are in the count, and as we get closer and hopefully get some more of these guys outside of our innermost hazard circle, we'll be able to do a calculation and get the risk numbers to you. But right now, we are definitely red for boats in the hazard area.
Copy that, RSO. Do you have an approximate time at which you might be able to do that calculation?
Yeah, each time we do it, it's going to be a little bit better than the previous one because they're continuing to move out. So the question is, when is the latest that you all want one? We can continue to do this down to T0 as we have in the past.
Yes.
I would recommend, just looking at the way things are going, that they are seeming to be a little bit more responsive this time than in previous days. I would recommend that we go ahead and go forward in the count a little bit more than this.
RSO PM concurs, and actually, if we could do what we did last night, which is hold at 3 minutes, and even if you have to run another calculation right up and through then, just to give us a good chance, because tonight's our best weather night for science.
Understand. And we're in the middle of a calculation right now based on ship updates, so we'll give you that information as soon as we have it. But, again, we are going to be red even with this calculation, but we are getting better.
Copy, RSO. Understood. Thank you for the update.
Roger that.
Nassau's Life Facility Range Control Center. You just heard a discussion between the project manager for the range and also the range safety officer on our current status with boats out in the surveillance hazard impact area. And the range safety officer is reporting that things are starting to look better, that the boats out in that area are starting to cooperate and move out of the area. So hopefully we can get them to move in time for the launch. Our plan today will be to count down to our 3-minute mark, and we will hold at that point if needed. That today does look like our best opportunity, weather related, and with the winds and with the clear skies. Starting tomorrow, the forecast is for a little bit cloudier skies as the low off the coast of Florida starts to move northward. So again, our launch time this morning is 4:35:30, and so hopefully we can get the boats moved, and the calculations will come within the limits, and we'll be able to get this launch off.